Today, I'll be talking about erectile dysfunction, also known as weak erection or weak penis. But before I start, I would like you to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Thank you. What is weak erection? Weak erection or erectile dysfunction, as commonly known, is generally described as inability to achieve and sustain or maintain an erection strong enough for suitable or enjoyable sexual intercourse. As a matter of fact, it is estimated that about 1 in every 10 adult males suffer from erectile dysfunction or weak erection on a long-term basis, according to the Cleveland Medical Journal. However, many of those people will be shy to come forward for assistance or help because most of them will want to keep it secret to themselves and they will not want to come open so that they can be assisted. The failure to get an erection is less than 20% of the 20% of the time. It's not unusual. However, when there is failure of up to 50% to get erection, that is when it's advisable to seek medical assistance. Before I continue, I would like you to subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell. Thank you. What causes weak erection or erectile dysfunction? The following that I'm going to mention are the major causes of weak erection or erectile dysfunction. First and foremost, it's made up of blood vessels which supply blood to the penis, especially during erection. When there is blockage in the those blood vessels, it can lead to weak erection. And also, people that have underlying medical condition like diabetes, hypertension, stroke are also having the possibility of having weak erection because the nerves or the nerves that supply impulses or electrical signal from the brain to the penis will be damaged as a result of those underlying medical condition. So this can result to ED for those patients. It is important to note that mental health can be also responsible for erectile dysfunction or weak erection. Mental health like anxiety and depression and stress. When an individual is so stressed, it can affect your libido and your psyche, which will make the person to experience erectile dysfunction. We are approaching very interesting topic. But before I continue, I would like you to subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell. Thank you. What are the possible burden an individual with ED experience? That is, people, the burden of weak erection. It can lead to argument and breakdown of relationship. It can also, in many couples have problem in their relationship, which resulting in anger and yelling, especially in the bedroom. Another burden which weak erection or ED can bring forth is frustration in the marriage, which can possibly lead to divorce in the long run. I know many of you be wondering about what are the possible causes of erectile dysfunction. Weak erection are caused by many factors, but let me start with the first one: drugs. A lot of drugs causes weak erection or erectile dysfunction. Not the drugs, as which is ED, is a possible adverse effect of many medication used in treating different or other medical conditions. As a matter of necessity, any individual on a particular medication experiencing weak erection should stop the medication immediately and see his doctor. However, if the ED continues after stopping the medication or the drugs, the individual should contact his doctor immediately. Before I continue, I would like you to subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell. I know many of you will be wondering, what are the possible medications that can cause weak erection? And the list is as follows. We have a lot of them. These are the conventional, most of them are the conventional drugs which we are taking. A lot of drugs like the diuretics. Diuretics, as we know, is the first line medication in the management of high blood pressure. We also have other antihypertensive too, which also can cause erectile dysfunction. A lot of other medication too, like antihistamine, antidepressant, muscle relaxant, alcohol, non-conventional drug like the marijuana, cocaine, a lot of them can cause possible adverse effects like erectile dysfunction. That is why it's important for us to be careful in taking any drugs without prescription and pharmacist counsel. I know some of us be wondering, how can one detect weak erection? Weak erection or erectile dysfunction result from a lot of etiology, meaning many causes. In view of the above, it's only rational to start treatment when the cause is determined or known. What that means invariably is that you can't just start treatment without knowing the actual cause of a particular medication. And when the cause is determined, then it is only rational to start the treatment. And the doctor detects or diagnoses that an individual is having erectile dysfunction after reviewing the individual medical history, medical record, laboratory results or reports, and carry out series of physical examination on that individual. That is when the doctor deem it fit to say the person have erectile dysfunction. I will be discussing how erectile dysfunction is managed. But before I do that, I would like us to subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell. Thank you. Weak erection or weak penis, also known as erectile dysfunction, can be treated using various methods. But I'm going to list about five, the common ones which the clinicians use in treating and managing ED. First, oral medication. The medicine the doctor you normally prescribe, the precision medication, is the top on the list. Then the second one is sex therapy. The doctor also prescribe that for some patients because it's personalized treatment. What the doctor prescribed for Mr. A might not be applicable to Mr. B. The third on the list is penile injection. It's a form of injection on the penis to stimulate erection. The fourth on the list is vacuum device. Then the last is surgery. And I will be discussing each of them one after the other. There are seven non-surgical treatments for weak erection. The first one on the list is good for the good partner to be transparent with each other. That is, what I simply mean is that by really talking to each other sincerely without hiding anything from each other. Then the second non-surgical treatment for ED is bridging the knowledge gap by getting educational material that will help both couples. The third one is prescription medication. Like I said before, getting a prescription medication from the doctor. Another one is mechanical aids, like use of that vacuum device and penile constriction rings. It's a form of vacuum aid and penile constriction rings, which helps in stimulating the penis. Another one is psychological and sex therapy. penile injection therapy, which has been mentioned before, and the last one is hormonal therapy. If the above did not really, the patient is not really respond to the above, they can use hormonal therapy as the last resort in non-surgical management or treatment of weak erection or erectile dysfunction. In a short while, I'll be describing the surgical treatment option for erectile dysfunction. But before I do that, I will implore us to subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell. Surgical option, which involve fixing of penile implants through a process called penile prostasis surgery, which enable an individual to have erection whenever he or she desire or feel the urge. I will take that again. The surgical treatment or option for ED is a process of fixing of penile implants through a process called penile prostasis surgery. This enable the individual to have erection whenever he desire or feel the urge of having sex. Many of us will be thinking or wondering that if we actually erectile dysfunction or weak erection can actually be prevented. I will say yes and no due to the following. If the following recommendation is followed, I will take that again. Many of us will be wondering if actually erectile dysfunction can be prevented. I will say yes and no due to the following response. If the following recommendation is abided to, it may help in preventing erectile dysfunction or improve existing erectile dysfunction individual. The first on the list is healthy diet, that is, we should eat healthy. Another one is by cutting down on cholesterol level, both cholesterol and carbohydrates. High level of that should be cut down. It go a long way in reducing or preventing erectile dysfunction. Then sedentary lifestyle. What that simply means is that staying idle, lack of physical activity can also result in, is another possible cause of erectile dysfunction. Regular exercise is very important and crucial in helping us preventing weak erection. In conclusion, but before I finish the last part, I will employ us to hit the notification bell and also share. Thank you. I will encourage us to subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell. Thank you. Some of us will be asking, what is actually the benefit of treating erectile dysfunction? The benefit is just straightforward to most of us, because first and foremost, it will help in restoration of peace and happiness between couples, improve sexual satisfaction among couples, and it has another advantage of aiding fertility in relationship. Thank you.